lot of people use cordless drills like this to drive in screws. There are even some so-called professionals on YouTube that can't seem to grasp the idea and do it correctly. So I'm just going to give you a few pointers and show you exactly how to drive in a screw correctly using a cordless drill driver. There are quite a few different types of screw head. That particular head is a PZ2 head. That can be driven in using a PZ2 bit. If you're ever confused and you don't know which bit you've got, if you actually look on the bit, you can often see the writing. If you look on that bit there, it quite clearly says PZ2. That will fit in that screw perfectly and that will drive that all the way home, no problem. A lot of people try driving in the PZ screws with a PH, which is a Phillips. So that's a Phillips 2. If you look at that, it will actually fit in there, but it's not a good fit. As soon as you start to drive that, when it starts hitting some resistance, that will actually what's called cam out, and that will start to push the bit out of the screw. You'll make a terrible mess of your actual bit, and you'll also damage the screw. So it's critical to get the correct bit for the actual screw that you are driving. So if you look at this screw, which is a black phosphated drywall screw, you can see that that has a Phillips head. This is a Phillips number 2. That will fit in there perfectly and that will drive that screw absolutely no problem at all. If you were to try and use the PZ2 bit in there, it will actually fit, but it's not a good fit. And as soon as you start to drive that, it will come out and you will damage the screw, possibly damage your screwdriver bit. So you have to be aware that they are posi-driv and also Phillips screws. The bits are slightly different. They will actually fit, but they do make a mess of the screws if you use the incorrect one. You can also get Torx-headed screws, like this very large screw here. You can see that that has a Torx fitting on the end. That has to be used with a Torx bit. That will fit in there perfectly. The beauty of these bits is they are very unlikely to come out. You get a lot of surface area when you're driving in a screw with that, and they are not likely to come out at all. And this bit is a PSD2 bit. That actually came with these screws, so you're guaranteed to get the correct bit for the screws because they actually sold together. And that gives you an extremely good surface area, very good contact, and that is very unlikely to come out. So to drive a screw, we're going to get the screw, we're going to get the bit, we're going to hold the screw so that it's straight, and then we're going to apply a pressure to the drill, a downwards pressure, and then we're going to squeeze the trigger gently. All the time we're going to apply pressure downwards and that will force in the screw. It's as easy as that. You'll notice that that didn't come out at all. Just remove that. We'll now do the same with a Phillips screw. Again, maintain an even pressure downwards, squeeze the trigger and drive it in. Very simple, very quick. We'll now swap bits again. We'll now do the posi-driv screw. Again, very simple to drive in, very easy. I'll now demonstrate how not to drive a screw in. This is one of the most annoying things, this really winds me up. You often see people, they'll use the incorrect bit or the wrong technique and they'll try driving a screw in and it'll come out like that. So it's quite simple. All you have to do is choose the correct bit, use the correct technique. That way you have a lot less chance of damaging the screw or damaging the screwdriver bit.